It's a fact. It's equilibrium. The ocean and the estuary at this high tide was in equilibrium. The ocean pushed in a little bit. Look at the birds hunting on the color line. Life is returning to St. Lucia estuary. Look at that. How beautiful is that? Absolutely, absolutely fantastic. Obviously, that grass beds and reeds will die down now, die back now with the salt water entering on every high tide. But it's a lovely, lovely sight. What a great achievement. Congratulate the team that took this bold decision to open the estuary mouth. Guys, it was the right thing. I didn't agree with you on the timing, but you nailed it. Look at this. Look at the beautiful interaction between the estuary and the ocean. What a great sight. This is what happens when a crocodile loses his natural fear for humans. This big crocodile hunted right in the front of us and it wasn't scared. There was a lot of other crocodiles around, but this one definitely lost its fear for humans. Look at this color line there where the fresh water and the seawater doesn't mix. I want to tell Nicolette Forbes, that's how it should be done. The estuary mouth can be open. Life can return. Look at this. The people are fishing. They're enjoying it. They're catching yellowfin bream, proper, healthy yellowfin bream, between 250 and 350 millimeter long. What a lovely sight. I cannot say it enough. Look at that, the fresh water and the salt water not mixing. As the ocean returns into the estuary, what a beautiful sight. Those people that's worried that Charters is going to run dry with the estuary mouth being open, that was one of my concerns. But here is the photos that's been taken this morning by Chris from Blackhawk Security. It's beautiful. There's a lot of water. It's clean water. Falsby and Charters is in good hands. You guys don't have to worry about that. Thanks to the Isimangaliso Wetland Park management team and the multidisciplinary committee that pulled this off. Excellent, guys. Excellent.